Where opportunities and dreams are realized. What that means is that where one lives, right, actually decides what opportunities people have. Home ownership is actually the quickest path to actually get out of poverty and accumulate wealth.
If you want to build wealth, typically building wealth in this country means that you bought a home, right? That you have accessed a mortgage. Well, you're not going to be able to access a mortgage right off the bat if you haven't had a credit history to begin with.
My parents are immigrants from North Africa. They moved to the States in the early 70s, and like so many immigrants, they needed a loan, and yet they couldn't get one. Banks just didn't know how to evaluate their riskiness. If you're from a community that has been historically left out of the mortgage market, as for example many Black Americans were, it's going to be very, very hard for you to qualify for additional credit.
Redlining is essentially the institutionalized discriminatory practice of denying an individual financial services such as mortgage loans based on factors including their neighborhood's racial or ethnic makeup. And the Fair Housing Act of 1968 outlawed this practice.
Historically, that was done through redlining. That was banks refusing to loan money to Black and brown people based on their zip code. Fortunately, now we are seeing machines replicating those types of traits. We can call it digital redlining, and I don't think that the everyday civilian is aware of the role that algorithms are playing in our day-to-day lives, not just with redlining. If you apply for a loan online, if you're applying for a mortgage online, there's an algorithm behind that.
Making the connection between risk and race, that decision was actually made by humans. Most of the data that we have around in housing now are actually byproduct of those discriminatory policies.
So while I think we've made progress in moving towards a more automated, non-human generated decision, we still have so many people who are left out of our credit system. They haven't been able to access credit in the first place, so they haven't been able to build up a credit history. And yet having a credit history is in part how you get into the system to begin with.
Algorithms have been used to determine whether someone gets a loan, whether someone is approved for a loan, whether someone gets offered housing. And when I say an algorithm, I essentially mean a set of rules that then feed into a machine, and then that machine predicts human behavior.
An average human underwriter probably could only underwrite, let's say, 10 loans a day. But now that we're using tech, you could have just a system or a process that is driven by algorithm making underwriting decisions that is probably as little as 1,000 or as high as 10,000 a day.
You can't have underwriting for the digital age and fairness tools for the stone age. Bias detection answers the questions, is my algorithm fair? And if not, why not? Bias remediation answers the questions, could my algorithm be fairer? What's the economic impact to my business of being fairer? And finally, did we give our declines, the folks we rejected, a second look?
In order to identify victims of algorithmic harm, we need to have avenues by which that can be investigated and ascertained. If an algorithm is involved in you not getting something important, like insurance or some other thing, you have the right to know.
And if you don't know why they made their decision and on what basis they made that decision, then yeah, you could just have an incorrect assumption that leads you to be denied a job or denied a loan or get different medical care. We don't know the scope to how wrong these algorithmic decisions, because we don't know how they make the decisions, and we don't really essentially know like when we've been impacted by them.
If you build systems that are designed to recognize the inherent flaws in these technologies and compensate for them, I think you can do good.
We want to make sure that every algorithmic solution can be explained to a consumer.
Essentially, the bare minimum, if you're going to replace a human decision maker with a computerized one, I think you need to make sure that actually works.
Humans should be involved early to make sure that the data itself isn't biased. Humans should be involved in auditing algorithms periodically. And so I don't think that technology is necessarily the solution. I actually think that human intervention is the solution.